This week on Patriot Vision, who won best float at the award ceremony? And SWAT is taking hold here at school, but on the way some might think. All coming up in this week's Patriot Vision.
Good afternoon, Patriots. I'm Chelsea Duchesne.
And I'm Duke Callahan. There are some cool new clubs here at the school.
Tyler Wilkie has more on SWAT Club.
Yeah, sure.
SWAT is a new club that focuses around those students with interest in magic and illusions. SWAT had its first meeting on Friday, September 30th. During the meeting, President Chris Rosebrough discussed what he had planned for the club.
We're going to be performing at a lot of major school events like Pack the House, and I know Student Council has something big for us in March. I don't quite know all the details on that yet, but we're going to be there.
SWAT stands for Students with Arcane Talents. The name is quite original, but it's funny how it came to be chosen.
SWAT stands for Students with Arcane Talents, and that's just an acronym we came up with because we already have the FBI club, the CIA club, so I figured we might as well have SWAT too.
Rosebrough is known throughout the school as Magic Man. He's extremely talented in card tricks and other illusions. He started the club to share his talents with others and hopefully teach them a thing or two. Though he is not in it alone.
I'm the director. I basically do anything that the president or vice president doesn't do. So historian, treasurer, secretary, whatever roles we don't have filled currently.
I think I was about 9 when I first started to get into it. And I started doing stuff with cards. And I figured out a long time ago that that's not where I should be. So to like 11 or so, I started getting stage magic really big, so that's where I am now.
Meetings for the club will be every other Friday in the classroom in the library. Stop by if you get the chance. What you see might take your breath away. I'm Tyler Wilkie, reporting for KTSN TV 15 News.
Homecoming was a big success this year.
Chelsea Duchesne has more on Homecoming Weekend.
This year, to start off everyone's homecoming spirit, the seniors cheered for their class to win Timmy. Although Timmy is the big prize, there were other class competitions, like the hot dog eating contest, to get everyone rallied up for the football game. The Patriots lost, but with touchdowns from David Franklin, Demetric Dimwitty, and Tom Ruddy, it was still a good game. During halftime, Erin Waterhouse was crowned queen, and at the dance, Noah Baumgartner won king.
It's an honor to be homecoming queen, and it was a really great feeling to be called to know that your peers chose you for such a great, honor, so it's a good feeling.
It's good to be the king. Yeah. I know, it was a lot of fun, and we had a lot of great candidates this year.
Homecoming takes a lot of work and preparation from student council, leadership, and the faculty.
It wasn't really any of it was hard. It was all fun. I mean, it was work, but it wasn't difficult. Decorations was probably the most difficult.
Everyone's hard work paid off, and many students said they had a good time.
My favorite part about homecoming was that the lights were off, and we still had fun, and people weren't getting up in each other's grills.
I think that people adjusted to the dance contract a lot better this year. Like, they learned to just, like, kind of work with it instead of go against it so much. So people had more fun dancing instead of just standing around like normal.
And it was really fun. Like, I thought it would be, like, crowded and everything, but it was just right.
I hope you had a great homecoming week in Patriots. Congratulations to Noah Baumgartner and Erin Waterhouse, our new homecoming king and queen. I'm Chelsea Duchesne, reporting for KTSN.
They are hoping to bounce back next year with young talent. Michael Frazier has more on the story.
With mostly sophomores, the tennis team's season ended with a record of 1-11. Inexperience played a role in the season with only few upperclassmen.
So many. We had a couple third place, a couple fourth place finishers in some really tough tournaments. You know, the main thing with us though is we were you know, a bunch of sophomores mainly and freshmen playing seniors and juniors, so we're getting a lot of experience that will hopefully pay off for next year.
Throughout the season, the girls felt they'd gone better, but the scores against tough teams did not reflect the improvement.
Season, we've gotten more consistent and everything, and like I said, scores. We might have lost a few, but that doesn't reflect how good we played.
The team is hoping to improve next year with returning players and more experience.
Everyone's improving, and I think next year will be a lot better. And we're just going to keep on pushing and keep on trying and just go from here on out.
Three sophomores are going to lead the team and improve with them for the seasons to come.
I'd say, like, well, we've got three sophomores on the varsity team that are all, this, my assistant coach and I are really excited about, that are here today. Emma Fuller, Kelsey Ritchell, and Courtney Martin, they're all sophomores, they're all on varsity. And, I mean, like, we really think, I mean, those are the three people that we're kind of building the team around for the next few 2 years. Those are going to be our top three players, I mean, because they put more work into it than anybody, and they've got good skills, and hopefully the team will improve as we watch these three girls improve.
For next year, the team is trying to build by getting more freshmen to participate.
Incoming freshmen, get them involved with tennis because we always like having more freshmen there.
Look out for the girls' tennis team next year. I'm Michael Frazier reporting for KTSN TV 15 News.
Last week was the annual homecoming parade.
Duke Callahan has more on one of our Truman traditions.
The annual homecoming parade is held the day before the game every year to promote school spirit.
Just, I think it really brings out the true meaning of every club we have. This is a good way to help, like, broadcast homecoming to, like, the other kids that usually, probably freshmen that don't really know what it is. My freshman year, we also did cross country. We had a banner we walked with. It's pretty exciting. I thought it was a very good freshman experience, just getting to know the school more.
But to some students, it's just about having fun and being silly.
I used to come, you know, back when I was a little kid, little girl. But I was a freshman. I played football, and I was on the freshman football float, so that was pretty fun. Favorite part of the parade was probably standing on the side and getting hit in the face by candy. You know, you just wave at people, just give them a little hello. Candy gets thrown at your face. Love it. Gosh. Coming back next year.
The homecoming king and queen candidates were also featured in the parade.
This year I'll be in because I'm on the homecoming court, but also because of football, and that's how I was the last 3 years.
The most important aspect is school spirit.
I really like the diversity in it. Like, I didn't know there were that many clubs in the school.
This is Duke Callahan reporting for Blue Team KTSN TV 15 News.
There's a new generation of freshman football players here at school.
They plan to have a winning season.
Not playing at the high school level, every player has their own opinion of this year's team.
This year's football team, we cool, we good, better than last year, progressed a lot during the season. So yeah, we cool.
What I love about playing with this team is everybody's hardworking. We practice hard. We don't give up. We have that mentality that we're gonna win every day. No one's a quitter on this team.
I like their intensity. They do have some swagger, and I enjoy seeing them come out. And they know what they are. And I like their intensity.
On a football team, all players need to contribute all their efforts to the team.
Contribute to the football team because I'm the center. I snap the ball. I have to block for the quarterback so he can get the handoffs, the pitches, throw the ball. And if the offensive line were to collapse, then the whole play would collapse.
Well, I'm a linebacker and a guard. And so a linebacker, anytime we run up the middle or anything, that's basically me. So I'm getting all the tackles.
Hey, wide receiver and safety. On freshman team, and what my job is, I catch the ball and do all that stuff. I block for running backs. I get the outside, and for safety, I just make sure no one goes deep, no one catches those long balls. And
in order to have a complete football team, coaches also have to do their jobs well.
They do their job really well because they help us out with our positions and show us how to, like, block and how to get through the line and how to close our gaps.
My personal opinion, I think we need to improve in tackling and blocking. The line need to get off the ball quick, but we're pretty good at that a little bit.
We need to improve on our tackling a lot and working as a team in our games so that we can be more successful.
Tackling, for one, from last game, penalties, and how do we respond after we get down a little bit?
But this team has a plan to improve on their weak areas.
Working harder in practices and working on our tackling and becoming more of a family and a football team.
This is freshman football. Work hard and put on a show. So make sure you stop by and cheer on our growing Patriots for future wins. I'm Michael Holman, reporting for Blue Team Patriot Vision, KTSN 15 News.
That's all we have for you today, Patriots.
Make sure to come out to tonight's football game against North Kansas City and have a great weekend.